The views and comments expressed on the following radio program by its hosts and their guests do not necessarily reflect the views of RMCOnAir.com or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
And good evening. Welcome. Oh, yeah, I like that. That sounds great. RMCOnline.com, Sonny Wells, Just Sports. This is the first of many. It's the 4th of July, you guys. And look, we just aren't ready to do everything the way we want to. But in studio today, we've got Cordell Sr.
Yeah, Black LaLanne.
Black LaLanne, yeah. Then we've got Mr. Dawuan Scott.
Yes, sir.
Came out with Magic as a rookie.
Oh, yeah.
And, man, when's the last time we saw each other? That's right, View Park.
The jewel of this inner city. 5 years, we graduated 100% of our kids. Sent 100% of them to colleges and universities when I was there. View Park, Gold Knights.
Yeah, you know what? We're just going to go some old school basketball today. We've got Dawuan Scott in studio along with his partner here, Dawuan Scott, the nutritional specialist.
That's it.
So we're going to start off with that, go back and forth a little bit. And what have you been doing since? Well, you know what? I don't know, like we were talking earlier, mm-hmm. I don't know your story. I know you from back at the Joe Weekly Run, Shoot, and Dunk, but I don't know your story. Tell us a little bit about what your story is about.
Well, you know, for me, the genesis began for me at Crenshaw High School. Willie West was like a father figure to so many. I was one of those that he basically put his arms around and
taught the facts of life. I was blessed to go there when Crenshaw was just unstoppable. I mean, it was the jewel of the city. And when I met you was during the summer pro leagues. It was the Rucker in New York City, and then it was the Joe Weekly Run, Shoot, and Dunk basketball
league right
here in Los
Angeles.
To the
money hole!
Everybody played there, from Will Chamberlain, Magic Johnson. I think one time, if they would have brought Kareem, they would have had the Lakers starting five.
Right.
At one point, you had to be like on the cover of Sports Illustrated to even get on the team, and I was playing with Hall's Furniture.
Yeah, yeah. One of the tough ones.
You know, so we won our little string of championships here and there. I went to Seton Hall University.
Mm-hmm.
I went to Cuesta Junior College in San Luis Obispo. I wound up going to play in France and made so much noise that Chick Hearn, a lot of people don't know, was assistant general manager of the Lakers at the time. So Chick invited me to the rookie camp, and after 3 days, the next thing I know, I'm at the Fabulous Forum in front of Bill Sharman and Jerry West, and I'm signing a 2-year contract, and they're telling me, Dawuan, you're going to be a Laker for life. Buy a house. And then they bring in Magic, and I'm like, oh, this is looking like a championship deal here. And for whatever reason, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar liked me. So he did not destroy me in camp.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So he'd give me advice. He'd say, you know, young boy, if you want to make it in this league, and we're talking about a guy that played 20 years, right? All-time leading scorer in NBA history. You got to learn to sleep when you travel. You know, it's the guys that can't sleep on buses and trains. And I knew so many guys that were like, say, in a car accident when they were young, they could never sleep. So we're on a flight. You look over, the guy's wide awake. You go back to sleep, you get there, and you got to play, time change, food change, you know, even the milk is different.
Wow, I learned that when I was with the Globetrotters traveling.
There you go.
Going over to Europe, the time changes there, and, you know, you don't know what time it is. You don't know where you are. Each night, you're at a different place because you're traveling on the bus, and then if you got to get a plane, you got to get a little small plane. And, you know, the few times that you have when you're maybe have a day and a half or maybe 2 days. Mm-hmm. You got to go to the gym and you exercise. You got to wash your clothes. You got to do all kind of stuff. It's a certain type of way to travel. That's why I only did it for a couple of years. I couldn't do that stuff, so, man.
If you factor in that,
the rest and recovery aspect.
There it is.
We were talking about earlier.
Right.
And he was telling me about, he gives, when I started talking to Cordell, he starts putting names to things that, like, what is a concussive trauma that your body has when you're playing sports?
Yeah, concussive sports, as opposed to doing things like yoga, which I do a lot of.
Kareem started doing a lot of yoga.
Yeah, Kareem was the first pro athlete that I heard of that they wrote articles about back in the day, back when he was vital. And he was practicing yoga.
Do you teach that, with your training and so forth? And
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Two methods, power yoga and the Bikram style yoga. And I do it in the heat also.
Power yoga.
Power
yoga. That sounds interesting. What is power yoga?
Power yoga is a 90-minute session where you actually just get into poses, and each pose has an effect. And each pose has an effect on all of the 11 systems that operate our body.
Now, would you suggest that for most professional athletes today, whether in whatever sport?
Absolutely. It'll help you in whatever sport. LeBron James does a lot of yoga.
Oh, that's why that boy like that, huh? Oh, okay. Now we're getting to the really meat and potatoes here.
Yeah, keeps the body and the joints, what we can just call open.
He plays bully ball. What do you think, Dawuan?
Yeah, man, he's a beast, man. And yeah. I haven't seen anything like him. So, the first time I saw Irv coming down the middle, that was gangway.
Yeah.
LeBron is just a whole nother animal.
Remember that dunk that he did on Michael Cooper?
Oh, man.
All right, let's get back to you because you're the focus today. Go ahead. Give us a little bit more about what you did during your career, and you got a few things happening afterwards too, don't you?
Yeah, one of the things is I was able to make the transition from sports into basketball. I started out with Budweiser commercials. The first, bring out your best Budweiser lights.
Okay.
So that ran for like 3 years, when commercials ran for 3 years, and that segued into television series. And then I didn't know growing up I would play a Bigfoot. But I've played more Bigfoot characters than anybody else in the history of Hollywood. Disney, Universal, Warner Brothers, Sony Pictures, you name it, I'm the Bigfoot guy.
And you showed me that picture. I didn't believe that was you.
Well, one of them had a guy named Kevin Peter Hall, starred as Harry and the Hendersons, and I was the stunt in the film, Stunt Harry, but we helped create Bring Harry to Life.
Okay.
And then when Kevin passed on, there was a television series for like 76 episodes, and so I took over the starring role as a television series, and it was bananas. I'd come to work, Michael Jackson would be there, wanting to meet me, and we'd do practical jokes on celebrities while I'm wearing $1 million Academy Award winning suit, so it was a whirlwind, so we did stuff like that. But it turned into, when Mike died, I was on a field trip taking some View Park kids to a special effects studio so that they could, see what they might want to do in life and look at the Academy Awards. And when the news came down, one of the special effects guys said, you need to follow through on what Michael Jackson told you to do, is create your own Bigfoot, your own, So I created a character named Big Feats, but it's F-E-A-T-S.
Okay.
And he is the only mascot for the environment.
In
the world that loves mascots, the earth itself doesn't have one.
You didn't tell me that earlier.
Yeah.
I did ask you a question earlier when we were kind of going over all of this. The question was, what would you have done differently? Because, you were in the league for a brief moment and you were out. What do you think you could have done that would have made you're successful, don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
But what do you think you could have done to maybe change things up? I think you mentioned a couple of things about
that. Well, I tell you.
A lot more stretching.
And my advice to young guys that are gifted today is that everybody, when you first fall in love Bill Russell said it better than anybody. It was an interview that he did with Jane Kennedy back on Wide World of Sports.
That was a nice interview, too.
And he said, he says, basketball is like a woman I love, but she only likes younger guys. And so
that's a good one.
So what I took away from that is when you first start to fall in love with the game of basketball, you love to do the things you love to do, but you don't work at the things you need to work at for an all-around game. And if you look at guys that have success, you know, look at Michael Jordan. He'll post you up. He'll take you down low. LeBron turned into a post-up guy also. I mean, you learn to do things, and when you're blessed with height, you just get lazy. You just want to dunk on people and block shots. But there's a lot of footwork that needs to go into it. And, mm-hmm. and until you get on that level when they start to dissect every aspect of your game is when you run into trouble. So my biggest regrets was not putting in all the work that was necessary for me to be a rounded ball player. Another thing for me was I got recruited by UCLA. You know, Gene Bartow brought me in. And my advice is to stay close to home. And I walked into his office, and that phone started to ring. And I was like, Coach, you're not going to answer the phone? And he's, quite frankly, Dawuan, we're under a lot of pressure here at UCLA. I'm like, oh, man, I couldn't commit because I didn't know if he was going to be able to commit. So I wound up going to Seton Hall, you know. But that's
who's the coach there?
Bill Raftery. Right. The kiss off the glass. Wow, Bill. Love you. You know, so he was a guy, but from basketball, you know, I learned a lot of social skills, learned how to interact with people. I learned the team concept translates into business, if that's what you want to do. Mm-hmm. Whatever you want to do, I mean, it's a good nurturing spot for you.
Now, you have a couple other things going on now that you wanted to give a little shout out to.
Yeah, I have a little clip I'd like for you to play. It's called Big Feats.
Spell that.
For the endangered. It's F-E-A-T-S. And I'll set it up for you. Big Feats is not only mascot for the earth, but he's mascot for the environment. But he has a superpower. And his superpower is he's the only creature on earth that has the ability to speak on behalf of endangered species. So it provides new bridges of communications for us to talk to hear what the bees have to say. They work so hard to keep us alive. And yet, in many countries, we're just, you know, they're on the verge of extinction, if not wiped out completely. So if we can hear from these things, then we can learn how to help with them.
Let's roll that piece. Hey, it's a great little piece there, man.
Thank you.
I want to bring in Mr. Cordell Sr. What'd you call him, Dawuan, the what?
I said the Black Lalanne.
The Black Lalanne. You heard of Jack Lalanne. This is Black Lalanne.
Black Lalanne.
We heard about kids at the high school level. They're going outside and they're playing and they drop dead.
Yeah.
My question is that usually some type of nutritional deficiency Well, I know you're not a doctor, but you probably seen kids fall out.
I didn't know that this was necessarily a phenomenon that's going on. Is that going on a lot?
I'm assistant coach over at Lawndale High.
Okay.
These kids don't eat properly. They're coming in there, beginning of practice, beginning of games, with Skittles. Did you eat today? No. That's the only thing you're going to eat is those Skittles and some Gatorade.
Right.
And then they perform poorly out on the court, and they wonder why.
Right. Definitely nutritionally connected. I think directly. There's a direct line there. So
let's talk about now, of course.
Well, before you change the subject,
sure.
There's something I work with some pretty gifted, brilliant people, I just have to say. And one of them has invented a thread. It's called thermocratic thread.
Thermocratic. Not crack it.
No, thermocratic. Okay. Thermocratic is one way to pronounce it. There's another one. I think it's. And it's so new that I'm still trying to get a handle on it. But this is what it does. It changes colors when it gets wet with perspiration. And according to your heart rate, the threads change colors to correspond with your heart rate. So when the redder it gets, the coaching staff can see if a player's out there in football field or running track, and they can't really gauge if he's on a danger zone. You can see by his clothes or the logo that he's wearing. And if you're jogging by yourself and you're pushing yourself too hard, you know, sometimes, you know, we have a tendency to do that. You know, Nike for years was just do it. But with this new ability for textile products, it's, you know, when to stop doing it.
Okay.
You know, and so it's seeking venture capital now. I mean, he's putting together a package. He just put together a video and sent it to me last week. I've been sharing it with people. I mean, the prospects are just, you know, phenomenal. You know, they just really revolutionize any type of, and then he brought up using it as swimwear too. Just because when the water gets wet, you got your swimsuit, so you can look good, and then depending upon the colors of the water, you know, so it has a wide range of uses, but it's pretty amazing.
Wow.
You heard it here first.
Yeah, okay. Yeah,
rmconline.com.
We heard it right here first. Now I forgot the question I was going to ask you. What were you talking about?
Well, we were talking about, children falling out. And it's nutritionally related. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, because you have to have proper minerals, you know, vitamins and minerals, not just sugar.
Yeah, and that's...
and sugar is a carbohydrate. It's a quick fuel.
Yeah, and they get it and they'll run out of it, and then they all of a sudden they're lethargic and they can't think, they can't remember to set the pick, you know, they can't remember where to go. And for a long time I was like, this generation of ball players, are they stupid? Are they stuck on stupid? What's wrong? So I have to think it's nutritional, because they get out there and they run, they get tired, and whatever was in their tank is out of the tank, so at that point they just can't think.
Yeah. Yeah.
So and it's widespread. Not only the team I'm involved with, but I see other teams and other athletes doing the same thing.
It's fundamental. Fundamentally, they probably are not getting enough fruits and vegetables across the board.
There it is.
Because fruits and vegetables will fix and balance out all those systems that we were talking about earlier, the 11 systems that make up the body.
Garden of Eden.
If you put the proper fuel in there, all those systems function properly, you know, including burning of calories.
You know what? I don't know the information, but I'll probably have it next week. Real quick, and then we're going to go to a DVD. San Antonio Spurs, all the old guys, vintage players. We have a situation where the coach basically emptied the bench and did not put a lot of pressure on his vintage players. Mm-hmm. I have to believe that they have a great nutritionist there as
well. They absolutely do, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And you know of him or...
I don't know who that is, but yeah, they do have a great nutritional program. Also, there's a couple of colleges.
Because, I'm sorry to cut you off, but the big fella cramped up.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Well, that had
Spurs
to
Spurs didn't cramp up.
Yeah, well, that
same
that had,
heat.
That had to do more with hydration. He's nutritionally sound. He's a top notch guy.
He missed the water. He didn't get to the water.
But you know what? You remember the gym too. The air conditioning went out, and when you're not used to training a certain way, and that's what you know.
He has a lot of muscle fiber. Mm-hmm.
And he
cramped up. It was a muscular thing.
I was told that's like salt. You need more salt in your body?
Yeah, minerals, salt. Sodium being one of them, yeah.
Anyway, thank you. You know Appreciate what, guys? Man, I'm so glad you guys came in.
We just came by.
Yeah, we're going to have you back next week. I probably think we'll have a little news on the current things, something we weren't able to do this time. Mm-hmm. But you guys saved the day. Appreciate you coming by, Dawuan. Knowing each other forever, you know. Pleasure to get you in here, too.
Thank you,
And we want to get you back, too, because of some of these other sports. I got a guy coming in next week who's a diehard soccer dude. He's just, I met him, I've been knowing him for a while, but we talked today. And he just knows everything about soccer, you know. And we want to talk about some of the nutrition that those guys really need. Because that's a lot of
running. Lot of running.
That's a lot of running.
That's my impression when I look at it.
It's like, I'm not running all that, chase that little ball and I can't put my hands on it. I'm not running that far. I'm not a soccer guy. But guys, thanks for coming in.
Absolutely.
I got three little shout outs I want to do.
Oh.
One to Coach Willie West, for all those that know Coach West, Crenshaw High School. You know, he had heart surgery about 3 weeks ago and he's recovering well. Much love to our father, Coach West. Also, we got to get the Willie West story done. You know, that's just something else. Byron Scott, we love you. Lake Show, let's go. B. Scott. Also, Ryan Hollins, the Clippers, played golf with his dad today, and we tied. And on that note, I'm out.
Okay, we'll be right back after we play a few bills here. Remember, we're brought to you by Pit Bull. We'll be right back.
Friend on kicking ass and taking names, brother.
We're gonna kick ass, we're gonna win it. I got a treat for everybody. Then we're gonna have some fucking fun and win.
90s Battlegrounds
dunk contest is going down.
A tether off, we gonna tether off the mother sucker. Tether off the sucker. A tether off, we gonna tether off the mother sucker. Tether off the sucker. A tether off, we gonna tether off the
Nike Battlegrounds League, second season. We started off with eight teams: JBL, Pasadena, Panthers, Hoopology, Southern Cal Pros, and Interscope. But we're down to two teams: Ameri Can and Showtime. And you know what? Let's battle.
RMCOnline.com. You're watching the Nike Battlegrounds League.